Grizzly Gaz, a popular YouTube channel, features Gaz and his French bulldog, Fendi, on their wild adventures through the UK. Gaz isn't afraid to push the limits, with this video showcasing hikes, camps, and wildlife encounters in some pretty remote locations. In April 2023, Gaz uploaded a video of a seemingly routine camping trip in the British wilderness. The first part is idyllic, Gaz setting up camp, chopping wood, and Fendi enjoying the sunset. However, the peaceful evening takes a turn. Missing from the edited footage is a strange encounter. A man named Martin approaches Gaz's campsite out of the blue, requesting food and beer.
Right, we've got steaks on go now. Bit of ribeye. Pot boiling for some mash. And I've got a visitor. Creeped up behind me asking me if I had a light. Me pants. This is Martin anyway. I don't know him, but he's stopping for a steak,
just
so.
Just some random creep. Wondering about.
You weren't round here in a poncho a couple of months ago, were you?
I don't think I was. I could have been.
While the situation itself wasn't overly aggressive, the sudden appearance of a stranger in the isolated woods is undeniably unsettling. Martin's speech patterns also raise red flags. He seems disoriented and rambles incoherently. Later, Gaz reveals Martin is homeless and, over dinner, shared a story of drug addiction, leading him to his lost date. But things get even more unnerving. While tending the fire, Gaz turns away for a moment, only to find Martin vanished without a trace. No word of thanks for the shared meal. Fearing Martin might return with ill intentions, especially towards Gaz's potentially valuable equipment, a sense of unease sets in. Gaz decides to pack up and head home. An additional layer of mystery unfolds. Gaz leaves a trail camera to capture any nighttime activity at the campsite. Martin's behavior leaves much to the imagination. Was he simply lost and possibly under the influence? Or did he harbor darker motives? Gaz's decision to leave seems wise, especially considering the missing trail camera he finds upon his return the next morning. The unanswered questions and unsettling encounter leave viewers hanging, adding a layer of intrigue to Gaz's usual outdoor adventures. Taking whoopee cushion pranks to an outrageous extreme, this video shows a man seemingly relaxing on a couch cushion. Unbeknownst to him, his friends have secretly installed an airbag underneath. As he sits down, a loud explosion launches him 6 feet into the air. Instead of laughter, the man's furious reaction suggests a brawl might be the next prank on the prankster's agenda. The Facts by HowToHunt.com's channel thrives on inspiring exploration and sharing outdoor knowledge. However, in January 2022, a video emerged that sent shivers down viewers' spines. The clip features a group of teenagers reacting with terror to unsettling sounds emanating from the dark woods.
What is it? Get Trevor. Austin, get the light. Hey! That was not an elk. Where's that coming from? Get my keys. Oh, get ready. Everybody, get in my truck!
Nighttime in the wilderness can be a symphony of unfamiliar sounds. Foxes, coyotes, and bobcats all possess vocalizations that can mimic human screams. In this instance, however, the noises transcend anything these teenagers had ever encountered. The sheer volume and intensity, coupled with what sounds like a forceful banging on trees, leave viewers questioning the source. Elk are known to rub their antlers on trees. but the video sounds lack the characteristic elk clicking. Many commenters point out the disturbing similarity to human screams, leading to speculation of a person in distress. While some viewers suspect a staged production, the genuine fear displayed by the teenagers suggests otherwise. The one certainty? These young adventurers were fortunate not to encounter the origin of these unsettling sounds, leaving viewers to ponder the mystery that lurks within the darkness. Busted for a DUI, this woman went from belligerent to belligerent behind the wheel. The officer attempted to arrest her, but she repeatedly refused, urging him to calm down. In a brazen move, she strolled to her car, hopped in, and started the engine. The officer lunged for the passenger seat, only to find the doors locked. Foot on the gas, the woman sped off, leaving the frustrated cop behind. Jumping into his patrol car, he attempted a pursuit, but the drunken driver had vanished into thin air. After a fruitless chase, the officer was forced to abandon the pursuit. Phil, a YouTuber on the channel HikeSlam, has documented his outdoor adventures since 2017. His videos cover everything from gear selection to solo camping, offering viewers a glimpse into the world of long-distance hiking. On the event of Thanksgiving 2021, Phil embarked on an overnight trek on the Appalachian Trail near his Virginia home. The first leg of his hike seemed routine, but soon, things took a strange turn. Scattered along the trail, Phil found peculiar discarded items. Trash unlike any he'd seen before. What made it even odder was the presence of writing on some of the containers. Lyrics scribbled on plastic, seemingly tossed aside without reason. As Phil ventured deeper into the wilderness, the strangeness escalated. Nearing his intended campsite, he stumbled upon a series of unsettling notes.
The weirdness continues. There's a dead duck here.
Some contained cryptic poems, others delved into elaborate conspiracy theories involving federal agents. A third set appeared biographical, offering glimpses into the author's life story. Whether the note writer was responsible for the gruesome discovery nearby, a dead duck, remains unclear. However, the proximity and the condition of her notes, undamaged and dry, suggested a recent placement. Just 20 yards away from the notes and the deceased duck, Phil noticed a campsite with a tarp and a fire. Opting for caution, he maintained distance and continued towards his designated shelter. The next portion of Phil's experience wasn't captured on camera. He reported encountering two women with a dog, inquiring if he'd seen the culprit behind the unsettling notes, an animal carcass. Upon learning about the nearby campsite, the women became visibly frightened and requested Phil accompany them back to their car. Recognizing the benefit of increased distance, Phil readily agreed. They hiked in the opposite direction, seeking a safer location for the night. Thankfully, the remainder of his journey to the new shelter was uneventful. Phil set up camp, built a fire, and enjoyed a peaceful dinner, miles away from the disturbing discoveries. Nightfall brought Phil inside the shelter, where he planned to examine the camp log, catching up on stories left by previous hikers. Here, the unsettling feeling returned.
I'm gonna check out the shelter log here. I hang out by the fire. Almost every shelter on the Appalachian Trail has a shelter log where people write in their trail names and what's going on. They can write whatever they want in there. So it's kind of cool tradition here. So let's see what this one says. Little engine, back section. Hiking again, finally. It's nice and little trail magic. Ah, some comics and writing and stuff. All right, let's see what's happened recently. Holy crap. Wait a second. Well, let me adjust the camera here. This writing looks almost exactly like the writing that was on that garbage a couple of miles from here.
Despite being over 2 miles away and on the opposite side of the road from his original destination, the handwriting in the logbook matched the one on the notes and discarded items previously encountered. The content of the log proved even more unsettling.
2018, while I was incarcerated at the Okaloosa County Jail. What the heck? In solitary confinement, I figured the following out. Refer to Isaiah 28:15 through 9. This is the same ramblings from the guy that was on the other side of the river. That's kind of scary. Kind of weird. Those women down there said they were going to call the police on the guy. Wow, this is weird. It's just like it goes in one direction, then immediately goes in a completely different direction. And there's just so much of it. Like this line up here. Think grave robbery in an attempt to obscure the reality of Little Mrs. Wolf. Content. Come up with some more of those wicked schemes, JB and company, so I can show some more of your true character.
The author seemed to be a convicted felon with a troubled mind, leaving cryptic messages that hinted at danger. Given the approaching darkness and Phil's apparent lack of self-defense tools, the situation felt particularly precarious. As Phil settled into his tent for the night, his anxiety peaked. He returned to the shelter only to find a half-empty Gatorade bottle dangling from the ceiling with a chilling note attached. Written in the familiar handwriting, the message read, "Watch out for ye mouse, the dead do walk and talk." Shaken by this latest discovery, Phil attempted to sleep, his nerves on edge. The last thing any solo camper wants is to hear unexplained noises in the dead of night. Unfortunately, that's exactly what transpired. Stirring from his sleep to rustling near the shelter, Phil peeked outside, catching a glimpse of a lone figure with a headlamp. Uncertain if it was the note writer, he opted for a cautious retreat, making his way back to his truck in the middle of the night, constantly glancing over his shoulder for any sign of pursuit. Thankfully, Phil reached home safely. However, as of 2024, he hasn't uploaded another video about his Appalachian Trail encounter. The unsettling notes in the dead duck likely remain, encountered by countless hikers who followed Phil's path. The identity of the note writer and his potential intentions remain a chilling mystery. A close call in a crabby road. A dashcam footage captured a tense moment on February 16, 2020. A delivery truck driver hauling cement in Crabby's rural area swerved sharply to avoid an elderly pedestrian. The evasive maneuver caused the truck to tilt on a bend, dislodging several pallets of cement. The impact of the pallets hitting the road caused them to burst open, sending a dust cloud billowing towards an oncoming car. Thankfully, only a few cement blocks struck the car's front bumper. Both drivers eventually met at the police station to settle the issue. Thankfully, the situation was resolved peacefully. The delivery company covered the car's repairs, and the truck driver received a minor fine for reckless driving. Mexico's fight against drug cartels is a brutal reality, and police dashcam footage captures the courage and constant danger faced by law enforcement. The footage opens as officers traverse cartel-controlled territory. Abandoned vehicles stand as ominous markers, hinting at the tension that hangs heavy in the air. Suddenly, an eruption of gunfire shatters the silence, vividly illustrating the ever-present threat. In a heart-stopping moment, a bullet rips through the windshield, showering the officers with glass and creating an immediate emergency. Reacting with lightning speed, the police take cover, using the tunnel for desperately needed protection from the hail of cartel bullets. This harrowing glimpse offers a stark reminder of the daily risks undertaken by Mexican law enforcement officers in the face of relentless drug violence. Love Sundays, a YouTube channel run by Sean, showcases his solo adventures camping across the UK. In February 2024, a particularly unsettling episode unfolded. The video begins with Sean parking his van near a wooded area and venturing off for some exploration. After returning for dinner and another jaunt through the woods, he settles into his van for the night around 9 p.m. However, a rude awakening awaited him at 3 a.m., peeking through the curtains.
Being well, I'll see you in the morning.
Good night.
The car's just pulled up, and it sounds like they're walking around the van.
Sean noticed figures around his van, who promptly scurried back into their car upon seeing him. The car then sped away, leaving Sean alone and confused in the dead of night. The true extent of the visitor's mischief wasn't revealed until dawn.
Right, well, I think we should at least go outside and see how miserable the weather is. Door's stuck. What the actual? See that? So here's. It was obviously just people wanting to come out and just be funny, I guess, but how dangerous is that, locking someone in their van? Let me check the back door.
Well, there's nothing on this one because they wouldn't have been able to tie it to anything, would they? There's no way they could have done that door anyway.
Sean discovered his van door secured with zip ties. The motive remains a mystery. Perhaps the culprits intended to steal diesel fuel, fearing interruption if Sean woke up. Alternatively, they could have been locals deterring overnight campers from the area. Whatever the reason, Sean's experience serves as a cautionary tale for solo adventurers. Thankfully, he managed to cut the zip ties and return home safely. Love Sundays continues to document Sean's camping escapades throughout the UK, albeit with a newfound layer of vigilance. A wild police chase took an unexpected turn when the suspect, ditching the traditional getaway methods, opted for a pyrotechnic display. He launched fireworks at pursuing officers, but their resolve remained undeterred. Eventually, out of fireworks and likely out of ideas, the suspect reverted to running on foot. However, the police had closed the gap significantly and cornered the suspect. Briefly subdued, he made a final, desperate bid for freedom by jumping back into his vehicle and speeding off, leaving the police trailing in his dust. A seemingly harmless prank spiraled out of control in Delaware. The doorbell ditch, also known as ding-dong dashing, usually involves ringing a doorbell and running away. However, in this case, a 15-year-old took it a step too far by kicking a state trooper's door. The officer's girlfriend was startled by the noise, and the situation escalated dramatically. The trooper, seeking harsh retribution, called in reinforcements. Footage shows an unrelated child being forcefully removed from their home, and the officer's aggression didn't stop there. Despite attempting to disable his body camera, the officer's actions were captured on video. The disturbing scene shows him inflicting a broken orbital bone on the actual door kicker, leading to the boy's hospitalization. The excessive force and abuse of power resulted in the officer's swift dismissal. Creepy Outdoors, a YouTube channel featuring nighttime explorations of unsettling locations, took a particularly dark turn in October 2022. The uploader ventured into an unnamed remote forest, capturing his solo journey through the darkness. For the first few minutes, the video offers only the sound of the explorer's breathing, highlighting the courage it takes to navigate an isolated forest at night, perpetually aware of potential dangers, both animal and otherwise. Sparse commentary punctuates the footage, with no sign of another soul in the vicinity. However, at the 13-minute mark, a blood-curdling sound shatters the tranquility.
Oh, hi. What? I need to get out of here. Oh, boy. Ooh. Okay. That was creepy. I need to get out of here.
A voice, seemingly hundreds of feet away, screams, "I see you." The possibility of a coyote or fox replicating such a human phrase lingers, but the chilling clarity sparks a different fear. Another camper playing a cruel prank. The uploader's frequent vocalizations throughout the journey could have inadvertently attracted attention, making him an unsuspecting target for such twisted amusement. Yet the secluded location begs the question, who else would be wandering these woods? Adding a layer of unease, the timing of the yell seems deliberate. It erupts just as the uploader extinguishes his light, almost as if the unseen entity was waiting for that precise moment to unleash its chilling words. Thankfully, the explorer returned to his campsite unharmed and continues to share his outdoor experiences. However, the encounter serves as a potent reminder of the unsettling encounters that can lurk in the shadows, leaving viewers to ponder the true source of the voice and its chilling intent. A close call on the road highlights the importance of focus behind the wheel. On May 4th, 2022, a truck driver, likely seeking relief from the heat, removed his hoodie. This seemingly simple action turned dangerous when the garment obstructed his vision. His passenger, either unaware or hesitant to act, remained silent as the situation unfolded. The critical moment arrived as the hoodie blocked the driver's view, causing the truck to swerve off the road. The passenger braced for impact, while the driver, blinded by the hoodie, could only react helplessly. Disturbingly, neither occupant appeared to be wearing a seatbelt. Thankfully, despite the perilous situation, the outcome proved fortunate. Both individuals emerged from the accident relatively unharmed, the driver unscathed and the passenger with minor injuries. This harrowing incident serves as a stark reminder, even seemingly minor distractions can have disastrous consequences. Always prioritize focus and buckle up. Every ride deserves your full attention. Chihuahua, Mexico became the scene of a dramatic cartel takedown, showcasing the ingenuity and strategic thinking of law enforcement. The operation unfolded in broad daylight, with a seemingly ordinary convenience store serving as the unlikely backdrop. Unbeknownst to the cartel member, police had been tracking his movements. As he emerged from his red pickup truck, a meticulously planned operation swung into action. Having gathered intel, the police team devised a clever capture strategy designed to minimize risk. The moment arrived, and police vehicles swiftly converged on the target, forming a tight perimeter around him. This decisive maneuver effectively cut off any escape routes and left the suspect with no window for retaliation. Surrounded by a coordinated team of officers, the cartel member was quickly apprehended. The swift and successful operation highlights the strategic prowess of Mexican police in tackling organized crime. During a seemingly normal Call of Duty Black Ops 4 stream, popular streamer Dr. Disrespect encountered a real-life nightmare. While engrossed in the game, the sounds of gunshots erupted, forcing him to abruptly stop playing.
Oh, man! I'm just not finishing!
Returning visibly shaken, he revealed the terrifying situation. His house had been targeted in a drive-by shooting.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've got to end the broadcast right now. Someone shot at our house, broke the upstairs window. This is the second shot. Someone shot yesterday at our house. And someone shot again right now and connected with the house upstairs, right? You're driving by, right? You.
This wasn't the first instance either. Reports indicate similar drive-by attempts had occurred in the days leading up to the event, leaving Dr. Disrespect understandably rattled. The normally energetic streamer dropped his signature character completely, showcasing the genuine fear this incident caused. In such a high-pressure situation, prioritizing his safety became an unavoidable snap decision, putting the stream on hold. A near disaster struck the docks on New Year's Day 2016. A massive 20-foot shipping container, weighing in at over 3,800 pounds, toppled from its precarious stack, narrowly missing dock workers below. Thankfully, the container was empty, but its weight alone posed a serious threat. Quick thinking and swift action by the workers saved the day as they promptly cleared the area. Safety crews quickly secured the scene and meticulously examined the container for any damage sustained during its fall from the crane. This incident serves as a chilling reminder of the ever-present dangers lurking in the fast-paced world of shipping. Tight deadlines and massive cargo loads demand constant vigilance and strict adherence to safety protocols to prevent such close calls from turning into full-blown tragedies. The world of streaming can be a wild place, pushing boundaries and often blurring the lines of safety for entertainment. Streamer Willie Two Guns was no stranger to this. Known for his participation in drunk streams, where donations from viewers fueled excessive alcohol consumption, these streams, often featuring Willie and his friends, would occasionally spiral into dangerous situations requiring police or medical intervention. One such stream started off seemingly normal, following the usual pattern of heavy drinking fueled by viewer donations. As the hours piled on, nearing the 10-hour mark, things took a tragic turn. Willie collapsed, becoming unresponsive.
I had two more.
All right.
I had two more.
Okay, I got it.
Thank you, bro.
Why didn't you...
To the triple.
Huh?
The triple.
It's not a triple. Is it a triple?
It's the next line.
I don't know if that's how that
Look
works.
Look at me. Put that on me.
I would not live bleak.
Yo, Pierre, you want to come out here?
Danger Ranger sent $3. Okay, buddy.
Willie, what's up? Wake up. Oh, wait. If we flick it, it won't make a sound. Let's try the side. Nope. We knock on his head. Oh, it does make a sound. Listen.
Yeah, it makes a sound.
Bro, you need to get move from the spot and, like, find somewhere to crash.
Is there a mattress on this board?
Yeah, he needs this crash right here. There's an air mattress already laid out. All right, whatever, dude. I'll just leave him. But, like, I mean, look at him.
Well, what do you want us to do?
Help me move him to this mattress?
No, he's fine. He doesn't want to be moved.
Yeah, you're right. He's not even awake, so he doesn't want anything. I told you, bro.
What happened?
I don't know. What do you think happened?
He fell over.
Well, that's good that he was leaning on something.
Yeah, and I kept telling you he was going to fall.
Now he's on the ground.
His friends, accustomed to the excesses of these streams, initially treated it as just another drunken mishap. They attempted to revive him with jokes and playful nudges, assuming he'd simply passed out.
Is he dead?
No, he's breathing. I already checked. Watch this. Willie! Yo, Willie! You just won the lottery! Willie, get up! It's time for school, Willie. Willie, you gotta go to school.
Six,
six, 6:05, Tom. Six 6:05, Tom. Wait, let me do this. This sometimes works.
No, that'll kill him.
Sometimes I just wake
up. Turn.
Tragically, Willie had recently faced some medical issues and was on medication that interacted poorly with the alcohol and the potential head injury from his fall. This unfortunate combination of factors led to a coma, and 25 days later, Willie Two Guns passed away. School safety measures are paramount, but unfortunately, even the most well-prepared plans can have unforeseen gaps. Such was the case at Kenwood High School in December of 2014. A dramatic situation unfolded when a suspect, apprehended by police, managed to escape custody and take refuge in the nearby high school. The twist? The suspect, still handcuffed, blended in with the chaos of a lockdown. Mistaken for a student, he was ushered into an office alongside two unsuspecting female students. It might seem unbelievable to mistake a handcuffed individual for a student, but this particular suspect held a surprising connection to the school. Just 19 years old, he was actually a former Kenwood student, giving him a familiarity with the layout that aided his escape. Security footage captured the frantic moments of his escape, showing him running onto campus and disappearing into the building. Later video caught him racing down the school hallways. Once inside the office with the students, the suspect, incredibly, didn't act aggressively. Instead, he calmly informed the two students about the lockdown he himself had caused. He even requested they use the phone to contact his mother. Three more students eventually joined them. Yet throughout the 10 minutes the suspect spent with them, he never displayed any threatening behavior. Instead, he opted for explanation and a plea for assistance, a bizarre twist in an already extraordinary situation. Since 2016, Sam, a Cleveland, Ohio YouTuber, has chronicled his stealth camping adventures on his channel, Northwest Wind. For the uninitiated, stealth camping involves parking a camper van discreetly, often for free, in locations ranging from neighborhoods to remote areas. In January 2024, Sam uploaded a footage of a particularly unsettling stealth camping trip in the Cleveland woods. He parked his van at a nearby dog park, venturing a few hundred yards into the woods to set up camp. En route, he stumbled upon a shredded tent, an unsettling harbinger of things to come. Undeterred, he continued and set up his own tent. As dusk approached, a couple walked past his campsite, triggering a sense of unease in Sam. Experienced campers often rely on gut instincts, and Sam's intuition was firing warnings. However, he opted to stay and continue filming. The tranquility of the evening was shattered as footsteps grew progressively louder outside his tent.
Somebody, hang on. I don't know if they could see it or not through the tent. I don't think so. I'm leaning right up against the light, but somebody's walking around out there very close to the tent.
Sam's calls elicited no initial response, but after repeated attempts, his worst fears materialized.
They're walking around outside in circles.
Hello? Hello? All right, I don't like this. Hello? Hello? They're touching my tent. Hello? Hello? Like, I'm getting out of here. Hello? Hello? I don't know what this is, but we're getting out of here. Hang on. Hello? Okay, they're walking away now. What do you want? What do you want? I have a knife. Where's my knife? You're f***ing with me. With me here. Holy crap. Get away. What do you want? Hello? I can't see you. Hello? All right, I'm getting out of here. We're getting out of here.
Several commenters pointed out that acknowledging fear to a potential attacker might not be the best strategy. After a seemingly tense standoff, the figures retreated. However, upon exiting his tent, Sam found them lurking nearby in the woods.
Collapsed my tent on me. I don't know which way they went. I think they went this way. I see you. Get away! All right, I'm spooked. I don't like this. Get my headlamp on and we're getting out of here right now. They're just standing there. They're just standing there. What do you want? Leave me alone!
Shaken by the encounter, he decided to abandon his campsite and return to his van. Unfortunately, the nightmare wasn't over.
All right, they're moving again. I don't know. I'm getting out of here. We're going. I'll come back for this some other time. All right, get out of here. I'm leaving. Don't follow me. I don't know where to go. I don't know which way to get out of here. I smell your cigarette. I can hear you. I hear you.
Leaving the campsite, a glance back revealed the attackers ransacking his belongings. Terrified, he fled into the woods, only to see his pursuers in hot pursuit.
This has got to lead back to the main trail. I don't know where they are. It's all foggy up here. I got water in my headlamp. I don't know where to go. I don't see or hear anybody anymore. I hear them coming. I can't see the shadow. Here's a path. Okay, get me there. I'm recording all of this. I'm calling the police. All right, I'm back on the path. Back on the path. Okay. Get away from me!
Reaching his van offered a temporary sanctuary, and he drove home, recounting the ordeal for his viewers. The video sparked debate. Some viewers accused Sam of fabrication, arguing that filming wouldn't be a priority during a panicked escape. However, his reaction appeared genuine. People react differently in high-pressure situations. The identity and motive of his attackers remain a mystery. Perhaps it was a cruel prank, but the attackers left his belongings behind, suggesting theft wasn't their primary objective. While the what-if scenario of not fleeing is unsettling, Sam's decision to escape was likely the best course of action under the circumstances. Imagine waking to the terrifying sound of a lion's roar. A camper spent a sleepless night listening to the king of the jungle howl near their tent, but dawn brought no relief. Instead, the massive predator remained, its presence a constant threat. With a surge of courage, the camper peeked out, coming face to face with a beast. It was everything they'd feared, a powerful creature capable of destroying their camp in an instant. Thankfully, after a tense inspection, the lion turned its attention elsewhere, leaving the ripped tent as a chilling reminder of its visit. As dusk descends over Mexico, we embark on a tense journey into cartel-controlled territory. Our car navigates deserted streets, venturing into areas considered off-limits to outsiders. The sparse streetlights cast an eerie glow, barely illuminating the complexities of this region, a haven for drug trafficking and cartel hideouts. The atmosphere crackles with tension. Each shadowy corner and winding alley holds the potential for unseen danger. Night amplifies a sense of mystery, cloaking the surroundings in an aura of hidden secrets. One can't help but imagine countless stories etched into every wall and narrow passage. Yet within the palpable tension, an unsettling silence reigns. The absence of conversation underscores the courage it takes to venture into this lawless land. This quiet speaks volumes, a stark reminder of the ever-present risks and the bravery required to traverse such a dangerous path. Trouble can arrive disguised as the most unexpected things. A seemingly innocent baby bison lumbered closer, its curiosity drawing it towards the man. But beneath the surface of this playful approach, he knew the real danger. The closer it got, the more likely it would trigger the mother's wrath. The man stood frozen, his desire to enjoy the view eclipsed by the looming threat. Only when the calf wandered off and the mother's presence receded did he finally allow himself to relax, the encounter leaving a lingering sense of unease. CCTV footage has exposed a shocking act of organized crime unfolding in the heart of Nairobi's popular TRM mall. A group of 8 individuals, 7 women and 1 man, displayed a surprising level of coordination during a textbook store heist. The women, feigning casual browsing, skillfully distracted staff. The tension builds as they form a protective circle around a female accomplice. With remarkable dexterity, she conceals a stolen laptop beneath her dress, taking advantage of its flowy design to evade detection by surveillance cameras. Their practice deeds speaks volumes about their familiarity with such acts. The group exits the store calmly, the stolen goods hidden beneath their oversized clothing, leaving the untrained eye completely oblivious to their crime. Arrogance on the road almost turned into disaster at a military base. A pickup truck driver, clearly not paying attention to the stop sign, barrels onto the main road. Thankfully, the driver with a dash cam reacted quickly, avoiding a collision. But the offender slunk. Runs out fast, sirens wail in the distance, and justice is swiftly served. Military police are hot on the pickup's trail, ready to pull him over. The consequences for this service member are about to hit hard. A 4-week driving re-education program is mandatory, and refusal means losing driving privileges entirely on the base. This close call serves as a harsh reminder to everyone, even on military grounds. Following traffic laws is crucial. The scene unfolds like a high-octane thriller. A cartel member desperately trying to outrun captured by a police helicopter. The camera follows the action as the cartel's boat skims the water's surface at breakneck speed, the coastline stretching out behind them. The pounding roar of the engine creates a palpable tension, amplifying the immense pressure on the boat driver, who pushes the vessel's limits. Their desperate bid for freedom reaches a climax as the boat nears the shore. In a well-coordinated maneuver, the cartel members abandoned their vessel, leaping onto the sand and scrambling for cover. The relentless police helicopter casts a menacing shadow as it descends upon the beach, disgorging a team of officers who take up the chase on foot. The dramatic escape attempt leaves viewers on the edge of their seats, wondering if the cartel members will manage to evade capture. The internet is awash with people capturing selfies in bizarre situations, but sometimes these attempts go hilariously wrong. Take this Reddit clip for instance. A woman finds herself with a seemingly docile goat tethered to a fence. Feeling confident, she remarks, "It's trying to headbutt me," completely unaware of the impending chaos. As if on cue, the goat delivers a swift headbutt, proving that underestimating an animal's reach can have unexpected consequences. Ambiguity hangs heavy in the air as a line of vehicles stretches across a vast highway. The scene takes a dramatic turn when dozens of figures, all men and clad in full combat gear, bulletproof vests, and heavy weaponry, emerge from the cars. Their attire leaves no room for doubt. This is no ordinary event. The tension intensifies as some men patrol the line of vehicles, while others climb back in. The meticulous coordination of the convoy is evident. These individuals move in unison, purpose written across their faces. Their destination remains a mystery, fueling a sense of unease and sparking viewers' curiosity. Where are they headed? What is their mission? This cryptic display leaves viewers with more questions than answers. Buckle up for a thrilling story from the Cedar Park Police Department. This high-stakes mission features the K-9 unit in a heart-pounding search and arrest. Witness the tension build as officers strategize for suspect apprehension. Here's where things get real. The expertly trained Cedar Park K-9 unit takes center stage. These K-9 partners and their skilled handlers will showcase their incredible tracking and takedown skills. Don't miss the pivotal moment when the K-9 unit closes in on the suspects. Prepare to see the efficiency and effectiveness of Cedar Park's finest in action. This chilling glimpse into a cartel member's home paints a picture of a life steeped in danger and suspicion. The opening scene throws viewers into the heart of this reality. A weapon casually resting on the sofa, a stark reminder that violence is a constant threat, demanding instant readiness. The walls act as a chilling backdrop, adorned with an arsenal of long weapons. This constant visual presence of weaponry reinforces the dark and dangerous atmosphere surrounding these individuals. Scattered walkie-talkies and other equipment hint at a meticulously coordinated network, a constant communication lifeline within the cartel's operations. This glimpse into their living space offers a sobering reflection of the pervasive influence of violence and the ever-present need for vigilance in the world of cartels. A narrow escape unfolded in northern Poland, in the villages of Samrowo and Renet. A single train track connects them, weaving under bridges and highways. On August 17, 2017, construction on one of these bridges went awry. A large concrete slab tumbled onto the tracks just as a regional train was making its way through the Polish countryside. Passengers and crew were blissfully unaware of the danger ahead. As the train rounded a bend, the fallen slab loomed large. A cloud of dust and debris signaled trouble. Reacting quickly, the conductor slammed on the brakes, slowing the train significantly. This split-second decision proved life-saving. The train collided with a concrete barrier, but thanks to the reduced speed, the impact was a bump compared to what it could have been. Thankfully, no one on board was injured in this close call. Watertown, New York, a close-knit community of 25,000, relies heavily on local grocery stores for daily essentials. These stores depend on delivery teams to keep shelves stocked, but a June 2023 incident exposed a troubling safety issue. The familiar delivery team, accustomed to the challenges of smaller chains with tighter budgets and potentially neglected maintenance, encountered a significant oversight at a Watertown location. They had previously raised concerns about a misaligned loading dock, creating a tripping hazard, but their complaints were dismissed by corporate decision makers. Anticipating future problems, the team began documenting their deliveries.
And I got that on video.
Huh?
I got that on video. Yep. I knew that was going to happen.
What?
I knew this was going to happen. I have been telling them to get a power jack.
Oh, my shoe came off.
That almost landed on top of you, dude.
Yeah, you okay?
Oh, I suck.
Their fears materialized during a precarious transfer of goods. Nearly 2,000 pounds of bottled water and pet food teetered on the faulty edge between the loading dock and the truck. This event, captured on video, highlighted the dangers faced by delivery personnel and finally spurred management to act. Safety upgrades were implemented, including resurfacing the driveway, replacing the docking plate, and introducing more efficient lifting equipment. The Watertown incident underscores a larger issue: workplace safety, particularly the risk of tripping accidents. Research shows that slips, trips, and falls are a major cause of non-fatal workplace injuries, leading to lost work time and even fatalities. In 2019 alone, falls, slips, and trips accounted for a staggering 27.4% of non-fatal workplace injuries in the private sector. This incident serves as a stark reminder of the critical need for preventive measures to prioritize worker safety. The pressure of being alive can be immense, especially when faced with a sudden medical emergency. Streamer Lothar experienced this firsthand during a seemingly ordinary Hearthstone session. A moment of discomfort quickly escalated, with Lothar clutching his head and wincing in pain. Before anyone could react, he collapsed off screen. Thankfully, the story has a positive ending. Lothar received prompt medical attention after viewers alerted the appropriate channels. However, this incident highlights the unpredictable nature of streaming. Sometimes there is simply no time for a calculated response. In these situations, relying on the support of viewers and the streamer's ability to adapt becomes crucial. Dream in a police authority without the commitment? This Georgia man seems to think so. Footage shows officers from the Acworth Police Department responding to reports of a civilian driving a retired police car, complete with flashing lights, and using them to pull over other vehicles. Despite the clear impersonation, the man, 33-year-old Jaredson McKee, doubles down on the act. Pulled over by a real officer, he keeps his own lights flashing, offering little defense for his actions. The officer quickly cuts to the chase, asking McKee's department affiliation.
Hey, partner.
Hi.
Hey, I'm Officer Park with the Acworth Police Department.
How are you?
The only reason why I'm pulling you over, I guess y'all were, well, that's my chief of police right there. He saw y'all go around traffic. He was trying to figure out who y'all are with or what was going on.
Okay.
So he called out on the radio and asked for a Martin unit. That's why I got you pulled over.
That's fine.
So, I'll just let him come up if he wants.
McKee, remarkably calm for someone impersonating a cop, claims off-duty hero operation status. However, the police chief's questioning swiftly dismantles his fabricated story.
You want to ask who y'all work for, Georgia Metropolitan?
I'm off-duty hero operator.
Oh, off-duty hero operator?
How you doing, chief?
Hey.
I'm off-duty operator. I just working off regularly. That's my ID.
Uh-huh.
That's my badge.
Well, there's emergency lights.
Yes.
And did I see you using emergency lights to pull out into traffic on Lake Acworth?
Oh, no, because I couldn't get through, chief. You notice that's a standstill. So I flashed the lights looking to see me, but I was trying to get in the line.
Who do you work for?
This is my company. I'm an off-duty hero operator. This is my company.
Okay.
Yeah, I do it for no details. Yeah.
So you look like me, you're impersonating a police officer.
Oh, no, sir. I'm not impersonating, sir.
3657? Oh, okay.
We can't pace our cars, but we can do too fast revisions.
All right, Mr. Mackey, here's your ID back.
Thank you.
Look, given with all the light and permit and stuff that I'm seeing, I'm just going to assume everything's properly permitted and stuff for the vehicle.
It is, sir.
That said, with what my chief's observation, you know, the use of those are for strictly business purposes. You can't be using it to pull in the traffic, okay?
Yes, sir.
So I am going to issue a citation for unlawful operation for emergency vehicle, okay?
I beg of you.
I don't think you're a bad. Let me have your business card. I don't think you're a bad person.
No, I just don't want to get.
I think you're impersonating a police officer.
I don't impersonate police officers, sir. That's why I was careful. I present myself and my uniform. I'm a former police in the Bahamas. I don't have nothing to impersonate for.
We need real cops.
I know.
You could apply.
I don't want to apply for Acre.
Okay.
I don't want to apply for Acre.
Despite McKee's insistence on running a high-end client company, his charade falls apart. Facing charges of impersonating an officer, McKee's dream of an earned authority comes to a screeching halt with his arrest. A harrowing journey unfolds on the streets of Sinaloa, highlighting the ever-present danger lurking under cartel influence. A motorcyclist cruises down the road, oblivious to the chaos brewing ahead. Suddenly, a flicker of movement catches his eye, prompting a last-minute swerve to avoid a speeding car that tears past. His heart races, a close call narrowly avoided. The scene takes another unsettling turn as a container truck stops abruptly, hinting at a major incident. Despite this warning sign, the motorcyclist presses on. His decision is confirmed moments later as he encounters the source of the commotion, a looted container, now engulfed in flames. The charred remains paint a vivid picture of the violence that can erupt at any moment, a stark reminder of the precarious existence under cartel control. The immersive world of streaming can create the illusion of closeness between viewers and creators. However, the virtual nature of this connection has its limitations. A chilling incident occurred in 2018 within a VR chat room bustling with a variety of avatars. The streamer recording the session noticed a commotion as a fellow player crumpled to the ground, their avatar twitching uncontrollably. Uncertain if it was a prank or a genuine medical emergency, the surrounding players hesitated.
Whoa, Wendy is getting wacky.
Whoa! Oh, it is Wendy. I couldn't even tell.
All right.
I'm just gonna
Where's Rick?
Whoa, hey, what's the matter? Are you playing around or are you for real?
Is he okay?
The situation highlights the potential dangers of VR and video games for those with specific health concerns. In this instance, a player's avatar with flashing elements is believed to have triggered a seizure.
Okay, dude.
Oh my god.
Oh my
god.
Are you okay?
You had us all worried.
Have you had a seizure before?
Yeah.
Are you just using your microphone? Because you shouldn't have the headset on.
Have you had seizure?
It's wireless.
Have you had seizures before?
Okay.
So, yeah, we're chill to sit here then.
Yeah, I think you just had one, buddy.
Did you just drop a seizure, man?
You should definitely go get that checked out.
Yeah, I think it's time for you to take a break, okay?
Yeah, man, this is gonna happen again. Please call 911 right away.
He's not on the...
Thankfully, the affected player was able to communicate with the others, confirming the seizure and appreciating their concern. While the virtual world couldn't offer physical assistance, the surrounding players did their best to offer support and encourage the player to seek medical attention. A chilling scene unfolds inside a car carrying presumed cartel members in Phoenix. Viral footage exposes the passengers heavily armed with long-barreled weapons, their attire a menacing mix of casual clothing and mandatory bulletproof vests. The car glides through the streets with an unsettling calmness, creating a tense atmosphere thick with unspoken threats. The potential for violence hangs heavy in the air. This brazen display of weaponry ignites speculation about a potential rebellion or a clash with security forces, a scenario that could plunge the region into a dangerous civil war. The heavy armament and the group's visible readiness raise serious concerns about future security in the area. Road rage can quickly escalate into a dangerous situation, as evidenced by this Reddit footage submitted by user PostRV4. The clip shows a driver following another car much too closely, even bumping it in a relentless attempt to get them to speed up. Filled with misplaced confidence, the road raging driver continues their aggressive tactics. However, their actions backfire spectacularly. The car in front slams on the brakes, sending the tailgater skidding into a hard stop. The impact is so forceful, it triggers the deployment of the airbags. This incident serves as a stark reminder of the consequences of letting anger dictate your driving. Arachnophobes, beware. This next clip, shared on Reddit by Poetic Yak, is guaranteed to send shivers down your spine. Forget the darkness, the claustrophobia, or the endless dirt. For this TikTok user, the true horror of working in a mine comes in 8 giant legs.
Scariest part of working in a mine. The mine spiders.
The video supposedly shows monstrous mine spiders, creatures so large, they'll make your average house spider look like a cute little friend. San Antonio grapples with a disturbing trend, a rise in car and weapon thefts linked directly to Mexican drug cartels.
Startling video. A young suspect with an AK-47 rifle going from car to car to see if any doors are unlocked. You can see other teens in driveways around the cul-de-sac.
Caught on CCTV, a brazen act unfolds at night. A young cartel suspect, armed with a menacing AK-47, prowls a quiet cul-de-sac checking parked cars. Sheriff Salazar paints a grim picture, revealing not only the theft of firearms, but their ominous destination, the hands of Mexican drug cartels. adding to the public's unease. The sheriff warns that stolen vehicles often become tools for drug smuggling. This alarming trend urges residents to exercise increased caution, emphasizing the importance of removing valuables from unattended cars. With stolen weapons fueling cartel activity and vehicles disappearing into the drug trade, San Antonio residents are left feeling increasingly vulnerable. Dashcam footage captured by Willis7747 shows a scene ripped straight out of an action movie, but with a dangerous twist. A man, in a desperate attempt to reclaim his vehicle, performs a daring stunt. As the tow truck hauls his car away, he climbs out of his moving vehicle and onto the back of the truck. Instead of resolving the situation through legal means, he detaches the car and speeds off the moving platform. This reckless maneuver may seem like something out of a Fast and Furious film, but the real-world consequences could have been disastrous. A trip through Sinaloa lays bare the tense reality of cartel influence. Our journey is abruptly halted as a group of motorcyclists are forced to a stop. Ahead, chaos spills into the streets, prompting them to veer onto a narrow side road. The extent of the disruption becomes evident as we navigate the dusty gravel path. Eerie remnants of past violence linger. A trashed container, now a charred skeleton, speaks volumes about the recent mayhem. The arrival of the National Guard confirms the gravity of the situation. These stalwart guardians represent a beacon of hope, their presence a critical measure to restore order amidst a cartel-fueled chaos. Their unwavering stance serves as a reminder of the ongoing struggle for peace and stability in this troubled region. Heart-stopping footage from Cranford, New Jersey captures a basement flood turning catastrophic. A lone figure navigates ankle-deep water, unaware of the impending danger. Suddenly, the relentless pressure gives way as a massive section of the basement wall explodes inwards. Torrent of water surges through the breach, transforming the flooded space into a churning torrent in a single terrifying moment. A haunting glimpse into the brutality of the Vietnam War comes from Reddit user Green Snakes, who shared footage from a museum presentation. The clip showcases a chilling array of Viet Cong booby traps, each one a macabre testament to wartime innovation. Razor sharp spikes are fashioned into a variety of instruments of pain, designed to maim and incapacitate unsuspecting soldiers. The presentation serves as a stark reminder of the constant danger faced by soldiers in the conflict, where even a seemingly innocuous step could have horrific consequences. A seemingly ordinary night in the Northeast takes a sinister turn for a lone driver. Cruising through the darkness, they encounter a chilling sight, an unauthorized checkpoint manned by a Northeast cartel. The quiet serenity of the night is shattered as cartel members flag them down, their demands unmistakable, a security tax. The air thickens with tension as the driver realizes they've stumbled upon an extortion racket. Apprehension rises as the cartel members demand a second payment. Deeming the initial sum insufficient, the driver is forced to negotiate, the safety of themselves and their passengers hanging in the balance. This unsettling encounter serves as a stark reminder of the cartel's stranglehold on the region, where even a quiet night can morph into a nerve-wracking ordeal. While pranking the police is a gamble, messing with strangers can be equally risky. You never know what someone's going through. In this video, a man films his friend pretending to water plants at a garden. As a stranger walks by, the gardener playfully douses him with a hose. After a fake apology, he does it again, a big mistake. The stranger retaliates by launching ceramic pots directly at the prankster's head.
You stupid?
Thankfully, no serious injuries seem to occur, but it's a stark reminder. Public pranks can escalate quickly, and you never know how someone will react. It's best to keep them lighthearted and avoid soaking unsuspecting people or risking a ceramic pot to the noggin. The world of live streaming isn't immune to the harsh realities of crime. Streamers, just like anyone else, can become targets regardless of whether they're broadcasting their lives or not. While some criminals might hesitate upon seeing the camera, others are emboldened by it. Hoshman Plays learned this firsthand during a disturbing IRL real-life stream. The incident starts innocently enough, with Hoshman cycling on a seemingly ordinary day. Despite the presence of others, a mugger approaches him. The tension escalates as the mugger repeatedly threatens Hoshman, demanding his belongings. The chat explodes with viewers urging Hoshman to inform the assailant that he's live. This tactic proves ineffective. While Hoshman initially manages to escape, he's later cornered and robbed. The mugger seems particularly bothered by Hoshman's attempts to disengage. which unfortunately escalates the situation. Due to the nature of the iPad recording, much of the altercation remains unseen. Though the mugger initially takes both the iPad and Hoshman's backpack, he ultimately ditches the bag. This incident serves as a stark reminder of the unpredictable nature of the world around us. While live streaming might enhance viewer enjoyment, it also adds a layer of chaos and uncertainty that can have real-life consequences. A seemingly ordinary yellow truck becomes the center of a tense situation as it's filmed stealing water from a private tank. Unaware of the watchful eye of a resident, several figures huddle around the tank, their intentions dubious.
See? I knew he'd be coming at us.
The camera captures the act discreetly. Suddenly, the truck driver seems to realize they've been caught. The vehicle screeches to a halt and lurches backward, facing the citizen's car. Tension mounts as the driver emerges, approaching the car and the recording device.
Well, people stealing water. I want to make sure that people, we're in a drought. I'll make sure nobody's stealing water. If you're illegal, you have nothing to worry about.
I'm sorry?
At all. No problemo.
The ensuing conversation reveals the truck's unwelcome presence isn't a one-time occurrence. Residents have witnessed similar incidents, prompting them to take action in response to the area's water theft problem. This brief exchange becomes a microcosm of a larger community struggle against water scarcity and resource theft. A visit to the library turned chaotic on January 24, 2024. Officers arrived at the scene after reports of a man causing a disturbance. It turned out the man had previously been banned from the premises.
Come back in.
Watch me come back in too. Watch me get back in.
Then you're gonna, get arrested.
I'm phone grab, bro. I don't give a f- I'll go too. Problem with me for no reason.
He doesn't want you back in.
Well, guess what? He's gonna get fired anyways. Guess what? This is gonna be the first time complaint on that.
That's fine.
The officers calmly informed the man of the trespassing order and explained he couldn't enter.
I didn't throw the snowball in the thing. Can't do shit. Can't even do shit. That's why you ass flees like a little b-. Hey, guess what? I got your ass through the 100
round. All right, get on the street.
You too, little pig ass.
Upset and demanding answers, the man's demeanor escalated. He became belligerent, hindering the officer's attempts to maintain order.
Man, you still got shit on back. Don't
step on me.
Niggas don't even touch me.
Don't step up to me.
Don't even touch me, then.
Back up. Back up.
Back up. Don't touch me.
Back up.
Despite warnings, he continued to shout and disrespect the authorities.
Touch me, see what happens.
Back up. The only thing that's going to happen is you get arrested.
For what? Nothing. For nothing.
Unclench your fist.
Make me.
Make Act me. Like an adult.
Make me. Come
Act
on.
Act like an adult.
Come on, I'm ready. I'm ready to go. I will knock both of y'all out.
Left with no choice, the officers were forced to arrest the man for his disruptive behavior.
Goofy. I'm not even doing shit. I'm trying to help you, bro. I didn't do shit.
Behind your back.
I didn't even do shit. What the?
Your
I didn't do shit! You grabbed me! You grabbed me, the f***!
He now faces serious charges, including aggravated assault on a peace officer, resisting arrest, and criminal trespassing. This channel has featured some wild robbery attempts, but this one takes the cake. Willis7747 sends us unsettling footage of a gas station robbery gone wrong. A man pumps gas into his car when a van pulls up and three men jump out, clearly aiming to steal the gas itself. But in a surprising move, the man at the pump doesn't flinch. He grabs the gas pump handle, drenching the would-be thieves in a spray of gasoline. Needless to say, this fiery defense sends them scrambling. Let's just say we wouldn't want to mess with this quick-thinking customer. Sinaloa, Mexico, a land ravaged by cartel conflict, bears witness to the chilling aftermath of Ovidio Guzman's arrest, El Chapo's son.
Is that Ovidio?
Cameras capture a scene that underscores the devastating ripple effects of such events. Two young boys, barely teenagers, sit inside a Sinaloa cartel vehicle, their faces etched with grim determination. Cradled in their hands are long-barreled weapons, a stark contrast to the toys they should be playing with. Their expressions betray a chilling reality. They are being groomed for violence, ready to defend the cartel's interests against the perceived threat of authorities. This scene exposes the human cause of cartel warfare. These children, robbed of a carefree childhood, are thrust into a world of violence and bloodshed. By arming these youngsters, the cartel sends a chilling message. They are prepared to fight tooth and nail, blurring the lines and weaponizing innocence in their desperate struggle for power. A dangerous prank known as swatting is taking lives and landing people in jail. Swatting involves falsely reporting a serious crime, like a shooting, to send a heavily armed police response to an unsuspecting victim's location. This footage captures Seattle Police Department officers responding to a reported shooting in an apartment building. Geared up for a life or death situation, they cautiously enter the building, weapons drawn. Knocking on doors throughout the building, the officers find only confused and startled residents, some facing the unsettling sight of a weapon pointed at them. Thankfully, this incident ends peacefully, but it serves as a chilling reminder of the potentially tragic consequences of this reckless prank. This YouTube video shows a tense scene in a classroom. Students crouch under desks in a darkened room. A teacher gives instructions as an unsettling announcement cackles over the intercom. A woman's voice asks anyone with a student named Jacob Peterson to email them urgently.
We're in need of Jacob Patterson. Jacob, do not exit the classroom. But the teacher who is Jacob Patterson in his room, please email Lori immediately, so that we can come and get Jacob.
Just a minute later, another announcement instructs everyone to stay put in their rooms. The school is locked down, with no entry or exit allowed. A tense silence hangs in the air for another minute before a final announcement declares the lockdown lifted. Students and staff are finally free to move around campus again. The video doesn't explain the reason for the lockdown, but it offers a glimpse into the fear and confusion students experience during such events. Trail cameras often capture the unexpected activity of nocturnal creatures. This clip showcases a tranquil nighttime scene on a forest path. However, the serenity is broken as a creature rapidly enters the frame from the right, displaying an unusual hopping gait. The exact identity of the animal remains a mystery. While viewers may speculate about coyotes, foxes, or even unlikely possibilities, the precise nature of this creature is unknown. Senior pranks are a tradition for graduating high school students, a chance for some lighthearted fun before leaving. But a prank in Niles, Illinois in 2023 went utterly wrong. Security footage shows a scene of confusion as police chase a runaway cow dubbed the Bovine Bandit through the streets. Apparently, students intended to bring the cow to their school, but things quickly escalated. The police, clearly unfamiliar with bovine wrangling, struggled to capture the animal, even with their vehicles. It was unclear if the cow was scared or enjoying its unexpected adventure.
What the f*** do we do?
I have no idea. Well, at least he's in the park.
Eventually, the cow was cornered in a backyard, but neither the police nor the arriving students knew how to handle the situation.
Or in that backyard. You know how to wrangle a cow? Yeah.
Easy.
Oh, he's going right through those bushes. No. Son of a
bitch. Oh. Well, it's stuck now. That thing is going to freak out. You guys couldn't just home with the cow?
Sorry.
Where's the thing? Where are we supposed to do to latch onto it?
It's coming.
I feel like all these 18-year-olds need a disorderly conduct ticket. That's what I think. Now you got three cops after we told you guys to go home, and this is the bull you gotta deal with because y'all thought this was a funny prank?
With tensions rising, local farmers fortunately arrived and safely secured the animal.
Hey, cameraman, that's not a good
spot. It's a bad spot. It's a bad spot.
Back up!
Gotta
go back. Back to this side. Back here.
Turned out the cow wasn't stolen, but it traveled quite a distance from Wisconsin. The prank resulted in citations for the students, including curfew violations and disorderly conduct. Police officers were attempting to locate a white Impala suspected of a traffic violation. Upon finding the vehicle, they observed it in reverse gear. One officer strategically positioned their car to prevent movement, but the Impala driver swerved to avoid being blocked. Another attempt to stop the vehicle was unsuccessful, as the driver reversed direction and fled the scene.
Freeze! Right now!
The officers pursued the Impala for a period, but ultimately lost sight of the vehicle. The chase was then discontinued due to safety concerns. A recent incident at a Johannesburg, South Africa mall raised concerns about the safety of in-mall aquatic displays featuring performers in mermaid costumes. During a performance, a performer's mermaid tail became entangled in the aquarium's rockwork. Fortunately, the performer was able to remove the tail quickly, avoiding a potentially serious situation. While mermaid performances can be a unique attraction for mall visitors, this incident highlights the importance of prioritizing performer safety in such environments. An unexpected encounter with alligators turned a kayaking adventure near Grand Harbor, Texas, into a heart-pounding experience for YouTuber Jordan Armacost and his canine companion Arya. While peacefully exploring the lake, Jordan spotted a menacing alligator lurking just beneath the surface, inches from his unsuspecting dog. Reacting swiftly, he pulled Arya back from the ledge, narrowly avoiding a potential disaster.
Arya, come here. Arya, come here. Come here. Come here. I for real think that was a gator right there.
But the danger wasn't over. As Jordan tried to navigate away, another gator materialized, sending shivers down his spine.
You better stay on here, girl. Sit down. Sit down. Oh, Arya, stay. Stay.
With Arya's safety paramount, he steered the kayak around and paddled furiously back to shore, leaving the gator-infested waters behind. Let's hope this experience serves as a cautionary tale, keeping Jordan and Arya off those gator-filled waters for a good long while. Flames lick the Minnesota highway as a car erupts in a terrifying inferno. Heroism unfolds as passing drivers slam on their brakes, rushing to save the life trapped within. Desperately, they yank at the doors, but the heat and warped metal hold them fast. The seconds tick by, each one a searing reminder of the dwindling time. One man, armed with debris, lunges for the window, but it proves no match for the car's defenses. Then a ray of hope, a DOT worker with the tools and resolve to shatter the glass. With a final heave, they pull the unconscious victim free, just as the flames begin to consume the passenger compartment. Kadir Tala, one of the rescuers, captured the heart-wrenching scene on camera. His voice trembles as he narrates, struck by the terrifying realization.
That could be me one day, you know? What would happen if I was in that situation and my life is on the hands of strangers that I don't even know? This is something that I will never forget.
Tola has spoken with the man he helped save and urges everyone to keep him in their thoughts. Though shaken, the story ends with a sigh of relief. No injuries, just a harrowing reminder of the power of strangers coming together in the face of danger. This powerful video showcases emotional testimony from victims impacted by a convicted child murderer. The footage depicts the perpetrator's reaction as each victim delivers a powerful statement in court.
Look at me. What I feel is so much deeper than I ever dare to express in a public forum. Chelsea was a sweet, loving, and innocent soul who could not have fathomed.
One particularly impactful moment involves the victim confronting the perpetrator about a physical injury sustained during the attack. This act visibly disrupts the perpetrator's composure. The video serves as a stark reminder of the lasting trauma inflicted by such crimes. A recent string of thefts targeting ATMs across the United States has highlighted the evolving tactics of criminals. In this instance, a group of robbers used a truck and chain to forcibly remove an ATM from a 7-Eleven convenience store. Surveillance footage shows the perpetrators displaying a disregard for bystanders, who were reportedly contacting law enforcement during the incident. Although the robbers successfully removed the ATM, they were later apprehended by authorities. It's important to note that ATMs typically hold limited amounts of cash, often only a few thousand dollars. Law enforcement officers pursued two suspects in an all-terrain vehicle, ATV, during nighttime hours. The chase initially occurred on a paved road, but the suspects veered off-road in an attempt to evade capture. Undeterred, officers continued the pursuit on an adjacent grassy area. For several minutes, the chase continued in this manner, with the ATV repeatedly entering and exiting the roadway, sometimes traversing residential lawns. Pursuit eventually reached a forested area with a path too narrow for the police vehicle. The suspects continued on foot into the woods, successfully eluding capture. The officers exited their vehicle and pursued on foot, but were unable to apprehend the suspects. Florida is known for its strict approach to law enforcement. This seriousness was evident when an 11-year-old girl in Volusia County made a false kidnapping report via text to 911. The report, according to the sheriff, was detailed, including specifics about the victim, vehicle, and kidnapper. Such reports require a full response, and police and sheriff's units mobilized to address a potential crisis. Fortunately, after about 30 minutes, the girl accidentally contacted the authorities again, allowing them to locate her. Upon discovering the prank, officers detained the girl and explained the seriousness of her actions.
They come, you can talk to your parents, we can open the window and let you talk to them. Nothing's gonna happen to you. Do you understand that? Okay.
I'm telling you this right now, you're gonna take this as a lesson at 11 years old that if you do something stupid in the future, you're gonna enjoy those cuffs.
I'm not gonna do this again.
You know, this is gonna be an opportunity for you to turn this into a learning experience. This is not something you're going to carry with you for the rest of your life, okay?
Hopefully, this experience will serve as a valuable lesson and prevent similar incidents in the future. Birthdays are often filled with joyful celebrations and unexpected moments. In this online video, a woman sings along with her loved ones during a birthday celebration. As she prepares to blow out the candles on her cake, they are extinguished suddenly. The woman's surprised reaction suggests this wasn't part of the plan. The cause of the extinguished candles remains unclear. While the internet thrives on mysteries, the exact explanation for this event may forever be unknown.
Happy birthday!
While concrete is vital for building our roads and bridges, wet concrete spills can lead to big problems. Take the unfortunate driver who slammed on their brakes in front of a cement truck, getting completely covered in the oozing mess. This incident serves as a stark reminder of the potential dangers unexpected encounters with construction materials can pose on the road. Drama unfolded at a railway crossing at Frýdek Místek, Czech Republic on December 11, 2015, grabbing headlines around the world. The incident captured by traffic cameras occurred during the busy morning commute around 7:30 a.m. A truck driver, seemingly oblivious to the danger, approached the crossing with flashing red lights and full swing. Ignoring the warnings, the driver continued onto the tracks, leading to a near disaster. A passenger train barreled through the intersection, slamming into the truck. The force of the impact was immense, splitting the truck clean in half. Miraculously, the driver's cab detached from the trailer during the collision, possibly saving them from being dragged along. Thankfully, the passenger train was spared any injuries as well. This incident serves as a stark reminder of the importance of obeying railroad crossing signals. In a YouTube video by DNA Paranormal, the team investigates a haunted care home.
Knock on the wall, is there another way?
During their exploration, they encounter a series of unexplained noises.
Nothing. You, who was that?
After a brief pause, they hear more sounds, prompting them to ask the spirits to make themselves known if they don't want the team there.
Clearly not impressed with the spirit box. Go then. If you want me to go, bang again. All the time I was down there, there was no bang. Except from the door.
Mm-hmm. The investigators then experience another noise, which they interpret as a response. In their view, this sequence of events delivers a clear message. The spirits are not welcoming the team's presence. A routine traffic stop has erupted into controversy after body camera footage captured the interaction between a police officer and a driver who refused to pull over for speeding. The twist? The driver behind the wheel was Monroe County, New York District Attorney Sandra Dorley. The footage released by the Webster Police Department has sparked outrage. It shows Officer Krista Foley approaching the vehicle parked in the garage. DA Dorley, visibly frustrated, admits she was speeding but questions the stop.
I'm the DA. I was going 55 coming home from work.
55 and a 35.
I don't really care.
She attempts to use her position as leverage, calling Chief Kohlmeier on speakerphone in a dismissive tone.
Telling you why I stopped you. You didn't stop at all. Did you not hear my lights or sirens or anything?
No, I didn't actually. I was on the phone.
Why are you so upset at me? I'm doing my job. You stay over here, ma'am. This is a legal traffic stop. Can you please stay over here?
Despite the officer's patience, the exchange escalates as she curses at him and retreats inside the house.
I understand the law better than you. Get out of my house.
Can you please go to the back of the vehicle?
I'm not going to.
How am I being an...
Thankfully, backup arrives. The situation de-escalates. In a pre-recorded statement, DA Dorley apologizes for her behavior, citing a stressful workday and concerns about her husband's health.
I've been humbled by my own stupidity, and I am fully to blame. I will make this right. I ask for your forgiveness.
Former LA Police Sergeant Cheryl Dorsey also expresses her perspective on the situation.
It was over the top with the way she treated the officer so poorly, so unprofessionally.
I am the DA.
A dramatic incident occurred in Arlington, Virginia in late November 2023. Officer serving a search warrant encountered a barricaded suspect inside a duplex. During the standoff, the residence erupted in a significant explosion. According to reports, the suspects may have been using a flare gun within the building. The exact cause of the explosion remains under investigation by authorities. Fortunately, there were no reported injuries resulting from the incident. Spooky footage captured on CCTV at an abandoned building has been making waves on YouTube, courtesy of the channel Horror Activities. The video showcases what appears to be ghostly entities. In one scene, a plastic chair defies gravity and levitates in the air. Then a figure seems to hover right above a security guard. The activity doesn't stop there. The same figure keeps popping up in unexpected locations throughout the building. One particularly unsettling moment shows the entity seemingly throwing something, possibly a shoe, down at the guard. These ghosts definitely seem to be enjoying some playful haunting. While their power level is unclear, it's safe to say most wouldn't want to find out firsthand. Quick action by a bystander assisted law enforcement in apprehending a suspected car thief in Florida. Police were engaged in a pursuit of a vehicle believed to be stolen. The chase culminated in a crash at an intersection with the suspect fleeing the wrecked vehicle on foot. A witness identified as a military veteran observed the suspect attempt to steal another car from a civilian. The veteran intervened, forcing the suspect to abandon the carjacking attempt. The veteran then pursued the suspect until law enforcement arrived and apprehended him. A Redditor named Leon is a ghost, lives in an early 20th century house with some unexplained activity. They describe it as a playful presence that enjoys things like flickering the lights. While some commenters suspect a hoax, others find it spooky because it's a classic trope of haunting. If you were in Leon's shoes, how would you handle a house with such an odd electrical issue and a potentially overactive imagination? Removing all the light bulbs indoors seems a bit extreme, don't you think? A rare incident occurred at an airport in McKinney, Texas, when a small plane malfunctioned during landing. Malfunction caused the plane to breach the perimeter fence and collide with a car on a nearby road. Fortunately, the injuries sustained in the accident were minor. Medical personnel evaluated everyone involved at the scene, and only one person required transport to the hospital for further observation. This incident serves as a reminder of the importance of safety protocols in aviation. A terrifying ordeal unfolded on a seemingly ordinary afternoon. Security footage captured the attempted abduction of a 16-year-old girl waiting for her bus on April 29, 2022. A man emerges from his car, grabs the girl's phone, and attempts to force her into his vehicle. The brave girl fights back, clinging to a fence, while the man desperately tries to drag her away. In a cruel twist, he uses her own phone to lure her before throwing it at her in frustration. Thankfully, the girl manages to escape as the bus arrives, forcing the assailant to flee in a white Ford Mustang. A witness provides a detailed description of both the car and the suspect, leading police to locate the vehicle at a gas station just hours later.
We gotta talk to you, get an ID on you?
Yeah.
All right. We'll talk to you in a second. Someone's gonna come and talk to you here and explain everything that's going on. You got an ID? All right. You put your ID out, my man.
Hey, ID, sir?
Well, someone's gonna come talk to you.
I'm going to jail?
No.
You got your ID on?
Huh?
No.
Oh.
You'd be out of the car in handcuffs right now if you were, my man.
Oh. I'm trying to
see. It's more of a... Not you. All right? Here's a driver if you need any.
I already got written down the stuff.
What's up, man? Why don't we get him... Why don't we get them separated?
Hey, De'Aaron, you want to come back and sit in my car and he can talk to you in private?
I'm in trouble?
No. If you're, like I said, my man, if you're in trouble, we already grabbed you out of the car and your car's in park and everything. You know him that well?
Yeah, that's my friend.
He wants to talk to her. Issue is her. So you can relax, man. I ain't bullshitting you. The main thing is her. So that's why I think he just... Yeah, no, the main thing is her. So that's why he's talking to her first, just... Yeah, so I mean, just relax. I can tell by the look on your face, you're like, what the... You're cool. If there was an issue, my man, you'd be handcuffed and everything else. You know what I mean? So just relax. It's all on her.
Despite denying involvement and refusing to answer questions, the man's actions are undeniable thanks to the security footage.
Him from this morning, after he left your house, you said between 6 and 6:30. He drove down Arlington to Neville. Parked his car on Neville, walked up to the bus stop at the corner of Arlington and Neville. There was a 16-year-old girl that was standing there waiting for the bus to go to school. He kind of stood around pretending like he was waiting for the bus for a couple minutes, and he grabbed her and tried to drag her back to his car. She grabbed onto the fence there, fought him off, and then when the bus started coming up, she started screaming, "Here comes the bus." What? So I don't know if he was going to sexually assault her, if he was going to rape her. I don't know what his intentions were, but that's what he did this morning. The whole thing's caught on.
I'm still filling him out, you know, but
Okay, so he didn't say about other than going to Minuteman. Did he say he went to Minuteman?
He said he was going to go there. He didn't say he did. He just said he didn't want to go there. We're kind of like in this thing where I'm trying not to have him have control over me. I'm trying not to have control over him. So I pretty much don't ask too many questions. You know, I just go and kind of, you know, as long as it's respectful, I don't really think that. All
right. Listen, I'm not telling you what to do. I'm just giving you a heads up that the best way to handle things at our age is to be honest. I mean, we're not 15-year-old kids where you try and lie our way out of it. But everything that can be recorded, in this world, man, there's cameras everywhere. So I ain't trying to bullshit you. I'm just telling you, I'm sure you've been to court and you see how things go in court if you're honest and cool. And
so full temper.
He does. It's in his wallet.
Charged with abduction, he receives a 5-year sentence, a penalty likely harsher due to a previous probation violation stemming from burglary and weapons charges. Notably, his release occurred just 4 days before his attempted kidnapping. Given the severity of the crime and his past offenses, do you think the 5-year sentence is enough? The crew behind the YouTube series Paranormal Nightmare TV series is tackling a notoriously haunted house rumored to have a dark history. Things take a turn for the spooky almost immediately, with the investigator experiencing unusual activity during a solo exploration.
Give me a name. Why did you scratch Lala?
What's the matter?
Something just touched my arm.
Whoa. What the f***?
Who was that? Who's back here?
He attempts to make contact with the unseen entity, and shortly after, another unexplained sound fills the air.
Your time here on Earth is finished. I don't know what happened to you.
What's in your hand?
It's a cell phone. That way you could talk to me.
Will their efforts to communicate succeed, or will they inadvertently escalate the situation? Unlike sudden storms, tropical weather systems can often be predicted. However, even with warnings, severe weather can cause significant disruptions. The northeastern United States experiences its fair share of tropical storms, and these events can bring heavy rain and flooding. 2023 floods in New York City were particularly devastating, causing widespread damage and leaving a lasting impression.
Oh my goodness.
From buildings with water leaks to streets transformed into temporary rivers, the city faced significant challenges. Despite the disruptions, residents continue their daily routines, showcasing the city's resilience. However, the floodwaters, ranging from several inches to a foot or two deep, posed significant transportation problems. Subways were inundated, leaving commuters stranded, while driving conditions were equally hazardous. Flooded roads resembled rivers, increasing the risk of vehicle stalls and accidents. The team behind the YouTube channel Dark Arts TV had a terrifying experience while using the Randonautica app. During their exploration, their friend Stacy vanishes without a trace. Reviewing footage, they pinpoint the exact spot where she disappears.
Look, she's there.
Oh yeah, she's there.
It's like she's quite dead. What do you reckon was the creepiest for her?
Because you're filming here, you can still see a torch on yours. And when you do that, you can... Could you remember seeing her there?
No, I've no. I couldn't see because the light was obviously in my face, so I was pretty blind at the time. You know when you can't see beyond the light?
Yeah.
Bro.
A frantic search leads them to a haunted well, then a creepy stone building.
I know where this is.
This is the haunted well.
This is the haunted well.
This is the haunted well, mate.
10 minutes away from here.
So he must have come like a back way into here then.
Must have been.
Yeah, but look, there's one.
That's a big size. Look at that. I think that looks bigger than mine. Look at the size difference.
Oh, yo.
Go put yours next to it. Look at the size difference of
that.
Yeah. It's locked up.
Aye, yo, it is.
Locked up?
Yeah, it's locked. Hey, no, it's not.
Well, it's not what?
Attention builds as they hear an unsettling sound.
Just anymore. Oi, bro, what the f***? Oi, where's that?
And catch a glimpse of Stacy, seemingly trapped in a stream.
What are you doing in the water, girl?
You're alright?
Oi, what happened?
You left me.
No, what? No,
bro, wait,
no,
did.
You weren't even. You didn't.
You disappeared.
You left.
Stacy's account adds another layer of mystery. She claims the group vanished before her flashlight died, contradicting the footage where she wasn't far behind.
I couldn't see you. I turned around, you weren't there.
You soaked
and wet. I went running through the woods to find you, and I just fell in and I couldn't see.
Where's your light?
Theories swirl, a time warp, memory manipulation, or even a zone like the Bermuda Triangle. One thing's clear, something strange happened in that place. On May 2nd, 2023, a chilling encounter unfolded in Browns Plains, Australia, captured entirely on dashcam. A driver cruises down a street when a woman inexplicably darts out in front of their vehicle. The driver slams on the brakes to avoid a collision, but the footage reveals a disturbing possibility. The woman appears to deliberately hit the car and feign injury. Adding to this suspicion, a man immediately rushes to the woman's side. The timing and the group of people approaching from behind the car further heighten concerns of a staged incident, especially considering the late hour. The driver makes the quick decision to flee the scene. The rise in popularity of home security cameras like Ring doorbells has led to an increase in videos online showcasing unexplained phenomena. This can be attributed to the sheer volume of footage being captured around the world. This particular clip features two women returning home at night. The second woman appears to hesitate momentarily before entering the house. Immediately following her entry, a brief visual anomaly appears in the doorway. The nature of this anomaly has sparked online discussion, with various interpretations offered by viewers. However, due to the limitations of home security camera technology and the brevity of the event, a definitive explanation remains elusive. YouTuber Ali H explores a spooky abandoned house, venturing into the dusty attic. Suddenly, he loses his balance and stumbles.
Is there anybody here?
You know what? I just realized.
I don't like coach. Whoa.
Was it an accident or something more?
That was me.
Ali brushes it off and continues his exploration. Strange noises echo through the empty rooms, raising the tension.
It's not something that is gonna pertain to you guys.
Heading upstairs, Ali feels a presence, a sense of being watched.
I'm asking you guys to stay here, remain here. I just saw something move back there. Who is that? Who's back here? Who's back here?
Though he sees nothing, the feeling intensifies.
Who's there? Oh, ow! Ow! Oh my, ow! What is the entity? Oh! Ow! 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 Ah! I almost cut myself in the face with this knife.
Undeterred, he pushes forward, descending to the dark basement. There, another unexplained event. A sudden push sends him crashing to the ground.
Stay back. Stay back. Stay back. I command you to stay back. You're not of the living. In the name of God, you have to live. Oh!
Did his presence stir up something paranormal? Or is there a more rational explanation for these occurrences? Allie's determination to explore despite the strange events leaves viewers to wonder, is he brave or just reckless? Check this out. A colossal male lion casually walks beside a car in Kruger National Park. These lions are accustomed to sharing the road with vehicles, so this big cat appears unbothered by the car's presence. However, despite the seeming comfort, interacting with lions is strictly discouraged. Their moods can change in an instant, and you never know when you might provoke them. That's exactly what happens here. As the driver slowly inches closer to the magnificent creature and stops for a video, he clearly crosses a line. The lion, the undisputed king of the jungle, lets out a short, sharp roar, a clear warning to back off. Needless to say, the message is received, and the lion continues on its way. This video presents an unidentified phenomenon. Two figures clad in black are seen traversing a remote area, exhibiting agility and movements beyond typical human capabilities. The purpose of their actions remains unclear. Whether it's a staged performance, a recreational activity, or something entirely different is open to interpretation. The footage serves as an engaging mystery, leaving viewers to draw their own conclusions. In the wilds of Australia, YouTubers Last Cast Lewis and his fearless buddy set out for a day of fishing glory. Arriving on a remote island, they scouted out a secluded billabong, a perfect spot to cast their lines. After some patient effort, a fish finally took the bait, but excitement turned to struggle as they wrestled to land their catch.
It's hooked up to a barrel. Decent size. Don't snap that, don't snap that. Drag it along. Walk it, walk it. We gotta be so careful of crocs right now. If we're not careful, there's going to be a croc that's going to come and grab us.
As Lewis leaned closer with a stick, a heart-stopping sight emerged. A monstrous crocodile, head barely submerged, locked its gaze on them. Thankfully, they remained unscathed. With a new appreciation for the food chain, they released the fish and hoped for more luck. Minutes later, Lewis spotted a telltale sign, bubbles breaking the water's surface, a croc on the prowl.
I don't know if you can see the bubbles, I'll try to zoom in. Definitely a croc. Making its way across here, straight towards us. So creepy.
Realizing they were pushing their luck, they wisely decided to pack it in. Let's just say their close calls were enough to send shivers down anyone's spine. This online video has garnered attention for its unexplained elements. A figure wearing a tape mask explores an abandoned building, emitting unsettling sounds. As the masked individual navigates the structure, viewers may perceive an unusual ability to move swiftly between locations. The figure seemingly reappears in its original spot, before vanishing again and ending up directly behind the camera operator. Regardless of its authenticity, the video undoubtedly generates a sense of unease. The Allegheny Paranormal Investigations team explores the historic Fairfield Infirmary, known for its troubled past. During a session, they attempt to communicate with any lingering spirits, asking for a sign with a simple clap.
Could you maybe clap? I can make an example. Can you do that for me?
To their surprise, a loud, distinct clap is captured on their audio recorder.
There it is.
We got it.
That's pretty cool.
She can't communicate.
Later, as they hold a seance, the team encourages any spirits to make themselves known.
While living here, present with us.
Hi!
No, that said help.
The tension builds during an Estes Method session in the jail room when unexplainable footsteps echo from the floor above.
I hear footsteps.
Yeah.
I hear footsteps. Is it footsteps?
Hello.
the team is the only one present in the building. Returning to the attic, a flurry of activity triggers their paranormal equipment.
Why is that going off?
Everything's going crazy right now. Everything.
But I don't know why that is going off.
As soon as we set it down, everything started going crazy.
One device seems particularly focused on a teddy bear.
That teddy bear, something is literally touching that teddy bear. That's the fourth time it's gone on now.
All right.
So,
could these be the echoes of children lost in past fires, yearning for some form of resolution? The team grapples with this possibility, left with more questions than answers. This driver makes a classic mistake, assuming an empty intersection means a free pass on red lights. Wrong. Running a red light at high speeds is just as dangerous, if not more so, than stopping during heavy traffic. A speeding car could appear out of nowhere. Our driver breezes through the red light, turning right without a care in the world. You might think he's outsmarted the system, but his luck runs out faster than he anticipated. There, right behind him, sits a police car. Busted. The flashing light fills a rearview mirror. And this day, or maybe even week, takes a sharp turn for the worse. This security footage from a child's room has sparked online curiosity. The video shows a child peacefully sleeping in a bed with an attached swing. Notably, the swing begins to sway back and forth despite the child remaining motionless. This unexplained movement continues for several seconds, with no other objects in the room disturbed. While viewers may speculate about unseen forces, the cause of the swinging motion remains unclear. Perhaps an air current or an unseen object could be the culprit. Looks like jealousy can strike even in the animal kingdom. This cow was basking in the attention of some visitors when out of the blue, a bison, watching from afar, decided it wasn't having any of it. The bison lumbered closer, circling the car, and with a disgruntled snort, launched a sneak attack, delivering a hefty swat to the unsuspecting cow. Talk about a petty move.
Oh, he's gonna ram him in the butt. He got up ahead of steam and ran it.
Both the cow and the surprised woman are left in shock. Did the bison succeed in claiming its war bounty of attention? We may never know, but one thing's for sure. This encounter proves that even herbivores can have a competitive streak. In a chilling collab, paranormal YouTubers Dead City Paranormal joined forces with Ghost Theory to explore a supposedly haunted abandoned house. Things get spooky when a sequence of knocks erupts after they ask the spirits to make a sound.
And then we can try and have a conversation with you.
That was a knock on.
That was a knock.
Yeah.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, that was definitely a knock on.
Make any sounds? You make any loud knocks?
One, two, three knocks.
Wow. This response to their question hints at a presence, but its intentions remain unclear.
Definitely
from in there too, because I can't hear it coming from my left.
Yeah.
Are the spirits simply acknowledging their arrival?
If you're touching that music device, can you let go of it? Can you walk away from it for a few seconds?
While the activity seems mild-mannered, one thing's for sure, it adds a layer of unease to the investigation. This dramatic security footage from Argentina highlights the importance of caution near train tracks. The video shows an electric train colliding with a dump truck that attempted to cross the tracks despite lowered crossing gates. While the train driver and truck operator were fortunate to escape serious injury, the incident serves as a stark reminder of the dangers associated with ignoring safety precautions at railroad crossings. In the desolate halls of Salford's abandoned police station, the shocked TV paranormal crew tread carefully. The whispers of the past hang heavy, fueling their paranoia.
Yeah, could have Max murdered or upstairs.
Don't say that. No, you don't. Which way are we going? Not that way.
Suddenly, a loud bang against the door sends shivers down their spines. Their investigation takes a terrifying turn as they chase the source of the noise, only to be met with a blood-curdling growl picked up on camera.
Oh, is he there?
Did you hear that bang?
Like you said before, it's like something's always one step ahead of you.
Then, in the inky blackness of a hallway, a disembodied voice cuts through the silence, followed by another.
Yeah.
You hear that?
Yeah.
Please tell me you heard that voice.
Carl.
Carl.
The question lingers. What restless entity haunts these former cells? My bet, a ghostly convict with a grudge. This terrifying clip from Dr. Fetus RN showcases the raw power of a tornado. Car in a parking lot becomes the first victim, who fade wildly by the ferocious winds. As the monstrous funnel cloud closes in, the car is effortlessly lifted and tossed aside like a toy. The debris field surrounding it grows as the tornado rips through the area, leaving behind a trail of unimaginable destruction. The clip ends without showing the full extent of the devastation, but the glimpse we get is enough to send shivers down your spine. The raw power of nature is on full display in this video from Tinnell Valley to Milnadu, India. Days of relentless storms and floods culminated in devastating consequences. The footage shows a house succumbing to the raging waters, slowly shifting off its foundation before ultimately collapsing. This heartbreaking scene serves as a potent reminder of the destructive potential of floods and the importance of preparedness in flood-prone areas. Panic almost derailed the investigation of a haunted house for the YouTube crew exploring the entity. The moment they stepped inside, unsettling noises filled the air.
What was that?
I think it's the wind. I don't know. This is what I mean.
Followed by the undeniable feeling of a nearby presence.
And then it felt like someone was literally here, right by me.
The activity escalated quickly, an undeniable paranormal experience leaving them shaken.
If there's anybody who can hear me,
oh my
asking for knocks. A knock tonight. Jesus. Why keep asking for knocks? A knock tonight.
The spirits seemed to revel in their fear, toying with them from unseen corners.
So if you want us to come back, that's all you have to do, and we'll. What was that? What was that?
I don't know.
Anika, was that you walking?
No, I'm standing still.
Something walking.
Oh, I just had a light on.
The team claimed it was just the wind, but the unsettling sounds whispered otherwise. This house, it seems, is undeniably haunted by a mischievous entity. This CCTV video captures a confusing incident on a deserted road. One man appears to become aggressive towards another, who subsequently falls to the ground. A brief visual anomaly appears near the fallen man, lasting only a fraction of a second. The first man reacts with surprise and flees the scene. The fallen man then rises, seemingly unharmed by the encounter. The nature of the visual anomaly remains unclear. While the footage has sparked speculation online, the limitations of CCTV technology and the brevity of the event make a definitive explanation difficult. Train car lootings are becoming a disturbing trend, with incidents like this one raising national concerns. The footage shows a scene of chaos. Ripped plastics, cardboard boxes, and paper wrappers litter the train tracks, evidence of a recent raid. Thieves target these trains for valuables like phones, designer bags, and electronics. This incident isn't isolated. Alarmingly, data reveals a 160% increase in cargo train thefts since 2020. The consequences are dire. In the same area plagued by vandalism, 17 Union Pacific train cars derailed, likely due to tampered equipment. The estimated cost to the company for these thefts and derailments, a staggering $5 million last year alone. Alabama resident Auburn Moore was apprehended by a SWAT team following an alleged armed robbery. Police reports indicate that Moore and another suspect, Jordan Hernandez, are accused of shooting a man and kidnapping his wife during the crime. Moore livestreamed the entire event on Facebook.
Show us your hands! Show us your hands!
Come out with your hands up!
Hands!
No people, no people. Do not move. Stand up and walk out here now. Get on your feet and move.
Leave the child alone.
Get on your feet and walk out here now.
Might as well shoot me.
Hey,
all right. Holy God,
walk out.
Judge.
Turn around.
I will. He's the only.
Okay. You're,
do not treat him like that.
Somebody get her.
Please don't. You're I just good. Had my book Come in my hand, my
good.
Bible.
You're good. Walk
out here. That's it.
Throughout the video, she displays a Bible and recites scripture while addressing viewers.
Chapter 37, The Ranks. In the name of God, the most gracious, the most merciful, by those angels who range themselves in close ranks, and those who drive away the wicked with reproof, and by the reciters of the reminder, your God is one. Lord of the heavens and the earth and everything between them, Lord of the east, we have adored the lowest heaven with the beauty of the planets and guarded it against all rebellious devils. They cannot overhear the higher.
Despite repeated requests from the SWAT team to surrender, Moore continues recording and preaching on Facebook. The video concludes with a SWAT team entering the residence and apprehending Moore.
This isn't how they do it. They're saying simply open the front door. If they had a search warrant, they would knock on the door, right? Right? But if they had a search warrant, they would knock on the door, right? Right. Just pray. Everyone just pray. This is Decatur Police.
Allah Akbar, please, Lord, be with us. It's just me and a little kid here, right now. Please, Lord, be with us. Allah Akbar.
A Reddit user named OKViolinist5341 is sparking chills with a video from their exploration of an abandoned mill, operational 1730 to 1950. They believe they captured whispers on camera, and viewers are divided on what they hear. Some claim to discern a specific phrase, while others report additional chilling whispers throughout the video. See if you can catch it.
Thank you.
The eerie atmosphere adds to the mystery, with OK Violinist 5341 admitting the place felt off, despite not hearing anything during exploration. Fellow Redditors are picking up on even more whispers, though the content remains unclear. So, are these whispers genuine ghostly voices? The evidence is certainly intriguing, and enough to warrant a deeper investigation in my opinion. What do you think? Can you decipher the whispers? An airshow tragedy unfolded during a race between a jet-powered truck and two inverted aircraft.
See, you can see it. Here comes the shockwave. He is coming fast. He is coming really fast. He's catching up. Looks like he has caught this time. He's coming up.
The high-powered truck, known as a shockwave truck, is capable of exceeding speeds of 375 miles per hour. However, during this particular race attempt, the truck suffered a critical mechanical failure, resulting in a rollover and subsequent fire. The driver unfortunately perished in the accident. This incident serves as a stark reminder of the inherent risks associated with high-speed racing exhibitions. The trucker's move is definitely in the head-scratching category. He drifts into oncoming traffic, oblivious to the danger he's creating. Stuck between a rock and a hard place, literally, he tries to correct his mistake by recklessly mounting the curb.
Well, oh my god!
Officer, thank you.
While he manages to regain the right lane, his luck runs out. A watchful police motorcycle officer witnessed the entire ordeal.
Yeehaw!
The officer cuts through traffic with sirens blazing, ready to pull over the truck driver.
Someone made a wrong turn.
Thank you, officer.
This bizarre escapade will likely end with a hefty fine, a stern lecture, and a reminder to stay alert on the road. This haunted cabin is giving Josko and Ben the scare of their lives. Josko's blood runs cold in the basement as he hears a mysterious sound.
What is that? Bro, I just heard like a girl.
Meanwhile, Ben's solo exploration takes a terrifying turn when a curtain billows in the breeze, on its own.
What was that sound I heard? Wanna tell me?
Julie?
Oh, that sounded like it came from over here.
And as if that wasn't enough, a dining chair decides to join the party by sliding out all by itself.
What was that? Oh. Okay, 1960s. Okay.
With activity like this, there's no doubt something paranormal is lurking in this old cabin. These YouTubers better hightail it out of there before they become permanent residents. On August 10th, 2023, police officers responded to a call at the William Knapp Emergency Department. The situation involved an 18-year-old female patient who allegedly assaulted two nurses. According to the nurses, the patient, who reportedly suffers from mental health issues, became upset because she wanted to leave the hospital, but her condition necessitated her stay. The nurses reported that the patient punched one of them in the leg and pushed the other.
She did what to you then?
Punched me in my arm.
Okay. Did it bruise or anything? I don't know. Is it red light that all? Is that just like, okay, sunburn? Okay, so no. And she was like, what was she doing before that? Like, why'd you?
She's trying to leave and she's on a court hold. So we cannot allow her to leave. So I'm trying to hold onto your arm while she's walking through the parking lot. And then we just let her go for a little bit. And then finally Drew grabbed her. We got her. She just sat on the ground.
Yeah, she, after that.
And then Lauren came out. And we kind of just like circled around her so she wouldn't get up and run.
Yeah. Sorry to you then. You just went out to assist.
Yeah, trying to get her back. I'm out there. I got out there. I told her to just sit down on the ground. And I walked up and she just like punched me in the leg.
Do you have injuries?
Negative.
Do you have injuries, bruising, anything like that? Anything visible? Okay.
The officers arrived at the patient's ward and arrested her without resistance.
The charge is still sitting there?
No, he said he doesn't have a warrant.
So you're going to take care of it, though?
Yeah.
Can I put my shoes on?
Sure.
Or my socks, at least.
Put them both on.
Got it. Thank you.
Advise, we're back in.
Copy.
The young woman was apparently aware of the reason for her arrest, assault on medical personnel. The charges, however, took an interesting turn. While facing two counts of assault on persons in certain occupations, both charges were ultimately deferred. This means the charges haven't been dropped entirely, but rather postponed, with the possibility of dismissal if the patient meets certain conditions. July 2023, police in Wausau, Wisconsin, responded to a call from County Market regarding a man whose behavior was unsettling customers and staff. When officers arrived, the man was no longer present. While gathering a description, they received information about a seemingly unrelated stolen vehicle. Surveillance footage showed officers responding to a stolen vehicle report. The owner initially believed a friend or coworker was playing a prank by moving his truck. However, he soon realized it was a theft. The suspect, identified as Andrew Hervey, was a Texas resident and a registered sex offender on probation.
PD. Is this a company vehicle or your personal? I don't know if this is going to make you feel any better or not. We do have license plate readers all over the city, and part of the reason why it took me so long to get here is because I was working on getting entered into that system and everything.
Me and someone were talking at the back window, and we saw someone walking up through the parking lot. Next thing, the person I was talking to was looking at me, he's like, hey, that's your truck. Honked the horn, and then he just kind of like drove up in there, so I thought maybe he was just younger, kind of, and he was playing prank and going to put it up their way or something.
Was he carrying anything with him?
I almost want to say he had a backpack.
We had a guy this morning. I don't know where he came from. His address is in Texas, but he's been in the area kind of causing a problem. I suspect that this is going to be the same person, but like I said, if he drives through town, it's going to alert on one of our cameras and we're going to find him. Typically, we find them still in the city, which is what I'm hoping for. Our dispatch center put out, it's called an attempt to locate, so basically everyone in Marathon County is looking for your trucker.
Dash cam footage captured officers approaching the stolen vehicle, which Mr. Hervey then drove away at high speeds exceeding 88 miles per hour. After disregarding a warning sign for a sharp curve, Mr. Hervey crashed into a ditch. Officers with drawn weapons apprehended him following a tense exchange.
At the curb north of the water treatment center, I can see his hands.
Show me your hands!
169, I'm out with her. Look at her.
Show me your hands! Show me your hands! Get out of the vehicle!
169, I'm out with her.
Get out of the vehicle! Keep your hands or I can see them!
169 for 43, we have one male stepping out. We can see his hands at this time.
Face away from me! Face away from me! Face away! Walk backwards towards the sound of my voice! Keep your hands up! Hands out to the side! Palms up! Do not move! Palms up! Palms!
Authorities later determined Mr. Hervey was under the influence of drugs, likely contributing to his erratic behavior at the store. He was subsequently arrested. This body camera footage captures a tense interaction between a New Mexico police officer and a family rushing their injured dog to the vet. William, his wife, and their 16-year-old son are visibly distressed after their labradoodle was struck by a car. The urgency of the situation is evident as William pleads with the officer to allow them to proceed to the vet, concerned that their dog is dying.
Driver, step out of the vehicle! Away from me! Hands on your head! Step back to the sound of my voice now! Now! Step back! Step back!
My
neighbor hit my dog. That's my son and my wife.
The footage shows the officer detaining William and his son while they explain the situation. Despite their pleas, the officer takes some time to verify the emergency.
To die!
I stop! You stop your car!
And I listen. Go run my driver's license. I have no warrants. I need to get to listen. That van.
I can't believe you pulled your gun on my kids, sir.
It's policy.
Unfortunately, the dog does not survive despite the family's efforts to reach veterinary care. This incident highlights the importance of clear communication in high-stress situations. Burned into your retinas? This image, courtesy of the YouTube channel The Bottom Line, is quickly circulating through Hindi-speaking YouTube circles. While the source remains frustratingly elusive, the image itself is unforgettable. A woman sits calmly on a bed, but the true terror lurks across the room. Near the doorway, a hunched figure contorts in an unnervingly inhuman laugh, arms rigid and head jutting forward at an unnatural angle. And if that wasn't unsettling enough, a final horror awaits. A ghoulish grin emerges from beneath the bed. The ambiguity of the scene only amplifies the creep factor. What exactly are we looking at? Is there a deeper meaning? These questions will nod you long after you look away. Let's face it, sleep is overrated until this haunting image is explained. A dramatic scene unfolded at a port in Taiwan as a massive container ship crane collapsed. These industrial cranes are designed to handle incredibly heavy cargo, routinely lifting shipping containers weighing tens of tons. The cranes themselves can weigh up to 2,000 tons, making them incredibly powerful machines. Fortunately, workers on the scene recognized the imminent danger and were able to evacuate the area safely before the cranes collapse. This surveillance video from a mesquite store captures a tense encounter between the owner and two armed robbers. The footage shows the store owner working on a shelf at the back of the store when two masked figures enter. Without hesitation, the owner retrieves a firearm and discharges it three times in the direction of the suspects. Fortunately, there were no reported injuries, and the robbers quickly fled the scene. According to reports, this is not the first time this particular store has been targeted by criminals. The owner has reportedly thwarted three robbery attempts in the past 5 years, each time demonstrating a willingness to defend his property. However, it's important to remember that such situations are incredibly dangerous, and law enforcement officials typically advise against civilian intervention during armed robberies. It wasn't your typical haircut day at the Lux Sharp Barbershop in East Hartford, Connecticut. Two barbers, Osvaldo Lugo and Rafael Santana, witnessed a heart-stopping scene unfold right outside their window. A little girl was sprinting towards a busy intersection, completely oblivious to the danger. Without hesitation, Lugo and Santana dropped everything, scissors and all, and sprang into action. Security footage captures their immediate reaction, a double take followed by a heroic dash out the door. Customers left bewildered, watching the barbers race down the street. Every second counted. Lugo managed to reach the girl just in time, scooping her up into his arms mere feet from oncoming traffic.
I immediately said something and looked back to see if the mom was behind her, but there was nobody behind her.
My initial reaction, it was just, I gotta get there.
Reunited with the child, Lugo and Santana embarked on a mini detective mission. They searched for the frantic mother, who had unknowingly lost track of her daughter. Eventually, they found her. This ordinary day at the barbershop transformed into an extraordinary act of heroism, proving that sometimes looking sharp means looking out for those in need. Chills are guaranteed at the notorious Indiana State Sanitarium, and YouTube's Project Fear team is here to stir the pot. As they delve into the sanitarium's unsettling history, the very act of reading seems to spark a paranormal reaction.
I hate when we read the packet and stuff starts happening.
Bro!
What?
What
was that?
Later, a crew member venturing solo is met with disembodied voices, a stark reminder they might not be as alone as they think.
hearing people.
Thermal camera footage reveals an unsettling anomaly in the building's exterior, further fueling the fear. Back inside, an SD session takes a chilling turn as a member witnesses something disturbing in the next room.
I just saw something move, like a shadow right in the room Dakota's by.
No way.
Dude, film that room quick. Right there, in that room, right next to Dakota.
While the evidence remains frustratingly unrecorded, the team's synchronized reactions speak volumes. What lurked in the shadows? The unanswered question hangs heavy, a testament to the unseen entities that may reside within the sanitarium's walls. Let's just say I believe their eyes. This security footage from a crosswalk captures a disturbing hit-and-run incident. The video shows an 11-year-old boy crossing the street with a woman pushing a stroller behind him. As they proceed within the designated crosswalk, an SUV blatantly disregards a stop sign and collides with the boy. Alarmingly, the driver fails to stop and check on the child's well-being. Instead, the driver continues traveling at the same speed, without even a momentary pause. Fortunately, the young boy manages to stand up quickly and appears to be unharmed. The woman pushing the stroller is understandably shaken by the incident, as evidenced by her initial stunned reaction. However, she quickly regains her composure and assists the boy as they complete their crossing. The quiet hum of a small town in northern Georgia, Villa Rica, was shattered by a dramatic scene captured entirely on CCTV. The Villa Rica Police Department, with their cameras routinely trained on a nearby railroad crossing, unwittingly documented a harrowing incident. One particular day, a truck driver made a choice fraught with danger, ignoring the clear warnings, the descending crossing arms and flashing lights. They attempted to cross the tracks. The situation escalated as the physical barriers began to lower. Concrete signal to stop. Yet the truck driver pressed on, their vehicle snagging the rear crossing arm as it descended, a final desperate message of the impending train. In a last-ditch effort to avoid the inevitable, the driver swerved sharply right. Unfortunately, the maneuver backfired, leaving the truck precariously balanced on the tracks. Frantic attempts to reverse and free the vehicle only compounded the danger. With no time to spare, a train barreled into view, unable to stop in time. The impact was substantial, the report noting the truck was carrying a load of raw meat, adding another layer to the chaotic scene. Some pranks go beyond the immediate situation and play a trick on a wider audience. This is definitely the case with a recent TikTok video by a user named Shacho Sabor. The video appears to show a prank taking place in Bucaramanga, Colombia. In the video, Sabor approaches a motorcyclist parked on the side of a busy street. They seem to be engaged in a conversation, and Sabor climbs onto the back of the motorcycle. However, things take a turn for the worse when Sabor makes some suggestive gestures. The motorcyclist becomes enraged and, after a brief argument, appears to stab Sabor and attempt to flee the scene. Chaos erupts as bystanders rush to help the seemingly injured Sabor. But here's the twist. The entire event was staged.
Ayúdenlo.
sí está bien.
No, es un celular.
The prank wasn't directed at the motorcyclist, but rather at the viewers of the TikTok video. This incident serves as a reminder to be critical of the content you consume online, as things aren't always as they seem. Thanks for watching. Stay vigilant, friends.